Dating back to the formation of the first Greek letter organization at the collegiate level in 1776, fraternity life has come to represent many different things during the formative years of a young man's life. Since their inception, fraternities have strived to shape future leaders and spread positive ideals across campuses all over the world. However, the positive image of the modern-day fraternity is sometimes challenged with troubling headlines across the nation involving alcohol and drug abuse, sexual assault, and hazing.
I gotta tell you that it really saddens me when these type of issues come up. And it more than saddens me, it angers me. So as Grand Consul, I feel I have a responsibility to make sure that these situations don't ever happen. And when they do happen, we are going to hold those brothers responsible and accountable for their actions.
The challenge to the fraternal reputation couldn't come at a worse time. Never before has there been a greater need for stronger, more ethical leadership in our society, the same kind of leadership fraternities were originally conceived to create in the first place.
I think there's a real need for true leadership in the workforce today.
And you have to realize that there's lots of baby boomers who are moving on and retiring. They're being replaced in the workforce by these millennials. And we're trying to work with the millennials to prepare them for the situations that they're going to face.
We need to find ways that we can train young people to be ethical leaders, to be effective leaders, and to lead from their heart.
To help brothers grow into influential leaders, fostering meaningful, healthy relationships with others becomes even more important with the most digitally inclined generation in history.
I think for somebody whose only connection is really on their smartphone, they're not really giving 100% of their attention and their listening to someone. But a person who really can learn and understand how to have a true social interaction, they really can touch somebody's mind and somebody's heart. Being stuck down in your smartphone, looking at your phone, that's not connecting. That's not impressive. But to be able to look somebody in the eye and be able to tell them what you're thinking, what you're feeling, those things are impressive. And those things are skills that we're starting to lose in our society. But I feel that's something that really gets developed by being involved with a Greek organization.
I think in everyday life, people come and go. But what's unique to the subculture, which is Greek life, fraternity and sorority life, is the fact that we have unique experiences and bonds that bring us together. And that just isn't found anywhere else but in Greek life.
Creating a safe place for young men to experience the gamut of emotions during their college years is a goal many fraternities now share. But in order for fraternities to get back to molding young leaders, they must first transparently confront the negative stereotypes that are often caused by actions of only a few members and chapters. Proving that these stereotypes are not reflective of the values that fraternities represent becomes paramount.
Really, the only way the fraternities are going to be able to maintain a positive image with the community is to make sure they stay transparent and active in the community. Otherwise, these isolated incidents will continue to typify fraternity culture.
In 1855, Sigma Chi began a journey to promote principally driven lifestyles that continues to this day. Before joining the fraternity, potential brothers spend 8 weeks meeting others in the chapter, learning about culture and setting goals well before their official admission. Friendship, justice, and learning are the cornerstones of the Sigma Chi experience, leading the charge for other fraternities in terms of accountability and integrity.
I am a Sigma Chi, which means I am a leader. Now, why am I a leader? Because I believe in myself. But that has not always been the case. It was my experience in Sigma Chi that helped me become the person I am. We feel that we can maximize our potential as human beings by associating ourselves with individuals of different temperaments, talents, and convictions.
Sigma Chi offers lots of programs for students to come and really grow as men, but the most important thing is instilling values-based leadership.
We offer a number of different programs. So we have some workshops that we go out and offer to the chapters on site with facilitators, alumni facilitators who've been trained to do those programs. For instance, there's one on responsibility and accountability. There's another on strengthening brotherhood.
I think that the Horizons Leadership Summit was definitely the most impactful experience I've had probably in my life, and definitely has been my favorite Sigma Chi experience. They flew us out to beautiful Snowbird, Utah. We went up into the mountains and really figured out what values meant the most to us, how those overlapped with the values of the Sigma Chi fraternity, and then how we're going to put those into action when we get back to our states.
Sigma Chi is also demonstrating ethical leadership through a $10 million fundraising pledge to the Huntsman Cancer Institute to fuel cancer research. Sigma Chi's members are committed to being the generation to end cancer.
With the Huntsman Cancer Institute in Utah, guys who have at least 2 years left in the chapter go through an all-expenses-paid intensive leadership development program for a week. And for many of the guys, that's a very personal experience because they have experienced cancer up close and personally. I have myself. I'm a cancer survivor. I lost my wife to cancer. And seeing the difference that we're helping to make in being the generation, these guys, to end cancer, I think that kind of thing says it all about what we're all about.
As a supplement to the array of programs Sigma Chi offers to increase responsible conduct and service to others, the Balfour Leadership Training Workshop is held over 3 days every summer. 2,000 Sigma Chi brothers come together every year to participate in the largest Greek collegiate leadership gathering in the world.
Certainly, we teach them the nuts and bolts of their various jobs, being the president or vice president or treasurer of their chapter. But more importantly, we want them to take lifelong leadership skills away from their time here in the workshop.
It's a very comprehensive program. Frankly, probably the most extensive program in the fraternity world. Sigma Chi has probably the greatest involvement of alumni among all the fraternities, and we're very proud of that fact.
The college experience is an unforgettable rite of passage for any student, but Sigma Chi is dedicated to making that time in a young man's life even more poignant. By answering the call their founders posed so many years ago, Sigma Chi brothers realize that their fraternity may have changed over the years, but the ideals of the White Cross continue to endure in an age when society has needed them the most.
When you're a Sigma Chi, you always say, I am a Sigma Chi. We are lifelong brothers.
I know that I'm going to be best friends with the Sigs in my chapter for the rest of my life because of the values that we share.
We are looking for remarkable men who have ethical values, who are going to be determined to change the world in positive direction.
To learn more about Sigma Chi or how to become a brother, visit www.sigmachi.org